Hey there, YouTube. Today I'm about to present to you 2013 Subaru Forester. In this video I'm going to show you the interior solid state serverless car. And so guys, here's the key. Let's start the engine. Let it run for a while. Lock, unlock. Alright. To lock the car and to unlock. Trunk release. And of course this car has aftermarket alarm with remote start, very aggressive front, accident free vehicle. There is no damage, no imperfection, no rust in this car. Factory multi-spoke aluminum rims, silver door handles, as you can see, very light doors and wide opening. Not bad. This car has 10 airbags, very safe car, 2-ton cloth seats, very nice. Three-spoke design, fully wrapped steering wheel. Alright guys, let's hop on in. Not bad. This portion with illumination. Alrighty. Subaru. This particular has 72,497 kilometers. Alright, let's start this engine. Horizontally opposed engine. Very nice setup indeed. Toyota. This car comes equipped with hydraulic assist bar steering, pinion, fluid steering wheel, loud horn, manual tilt, and telescopic to adjust. Use this lever right there, it's quite easy. Tilt and telescopic. Alright, not bad. Right now, guys, let's send the headlight, front rear fog lights, high beam, soul service lights. Looks like a candy. Not bad. Hot headlights right here and panel them. Power exterior mirrors. Huge mirrors, by the way, they also heat it. Not bad. And power folding. Hit this button right here. Very convenient feature, especially in tight parking spaces. Not bad. Turn up the traction control button right here. Alright, conveniently located right here. Chrome door handles and of course fake dark aluminum trim. Power window lock, door center lock. Driver side window fully automatic in both direction up and down. As you can see. And back windows. As you can see, back windows are fully tinted. Sweet. Alright. And of course, soft armrest. Very nice material. And this scratch right here and right here. But it's pretty common for this car. Right now, guys, let's open the head and take a good look. Take care of this car. Alright, let's open the head. It's quite easy. This car does have power moonroof, roof rails up top. And here's your antenna for your audio system. Not bad. And of course your huge taillights, little polished exhaust pipes, symmetrical all-wheel drive system, legendary. Tahak, tow bar, and quiet engine. Your factory rear view camera, license plate lights, and of course rear wiper, third brake light, and her defrosting glass washer right here. multi-spoke aluminum rims, 17 inch, tires measuring 225-55, front ventilated disc brakes and rear solid disc brakes, high flaps right here, knock-in tires, gorgeous factory rims. Alright guys, right now I'm going to show you underneath of this car. LED turn signal gears, thanks to our mirrors, very bright. Excellent coefficient of drag for this Subaru. Extremely quiet engine. Halogen reflector headlamps, headlight washers, halogen fog lights, chrome grille, and huge Subaru emblem. So guys, this car has a horizontally opposed boxer engine, 4 cylinder, 16 valve, dual head cam, 2 liter, normally aspirated. It produces 150 horsepower and 198 Nm of torque, maximum speed of 185 km per hour, 0-6 time is 12.4 seconds. Combined consumption for this car has around 8 liter per 100 km. The car is 4-wheel drive and the fuel tank is around 60 liters. Independent McPherson Stratus suspension with anti-roll bar front and double wishbone suspension out back. The trunk space is around 450 liters. When in folding area seats, it increased to 1670 liters. Main rivals for this car is a Mazda CX-5, Nissan Qashqai, Kia Sportage, Toyota RAV4, Mitsubishi Outlander, Ford Kuga and Honda CR-V. The Subaru Forester is a compact crossover SUV manufactured since 1997 by Subaru. Available in Japan from 1997, the Forester shares its platform with the Impreza. The independent double wishbone rear suspension has been redesigned for better handling and a smoother ride over the previous generation. The sport shift has been included with the 4-speed computer-controlled automatic transmission. The in-dash touchscreen satellite navigation system is Bluetooth compatible and has premium stereo integrated. Subaru also offers the 6-speaker premium stereo with surround sound enhancement separate from the navigation system. So guys, you have choice between different engines. 2 liter in our case, it produced 150 horsepower, then 2.5 liter, it produced 172 horsepower, 2.5 liter turbocharged, it produced 230 horsepower, and top of the line, 2.5 liter, it produced 263 horsepower. So guys, this Subaru really rocks.
Alright guys, right now, take a good look. The exterior, let's take a good look. The interior portion, the most interesting part. This Subaru rocks, definitely. Love it. Your twitches right here. And of course, main speakers, storage area, and door lights. Very nice attention to details. Of course, your tire pressure right here. Warning. Driver's seat has manual adjustment, standard seat height, incline, sliding right here. Quite easy to adjust. Very supportive seats, adjustable headrests and seat belts. And of course, your pedals right there and fuse box located right here. Right now, I'm going to show you. All right. Here we go. Pedals right here. All right, guys, right now. Let's see what kind of noise this beast produces. Awesome sound. Definitely not bad. Easy to read gauges. And of course, thick steering wheel, leather wrapped, it's all factory. Not bad. And here's your light indicator controls right here, and of course your intermittent wiper controls, including rear wiper right here. You can raise and lower the volume. I believe 8 speakers, 4 tweeters, can increase and decrease volume, different modes, seat control buttons right here, telephone controls, and for the telephone, specifically for the Bluetooth. Not bad. Alright, cruise control settings right here. Set speed, cancel. Overall build quality and all the materials in this car are very nice. You can find hard touch plastic, but it's well done. And your digital clock right here. It's hard to see, but right there, outside temperature, and your average fuel economy. Alrighty, and here's your infotainment screen. This cluster right here, RDS, tuning, and track, volume, power button, CD, auxiliary, MFM, stations, MP3 compatible, WMA, alright. How it sounds. Alright. Not bad indeed. Alright guys, screen off, sound settings. It's not a touchscreen display, quite easy to adjust. Back button, mid-range, and of course treble, balance, then you have screen settings, contrast, brightness, Bluetooth audio, and others. Alright, that's pretty much it for this display. Easy to use indeed. Your vents right here, single zone, fully automatic climate control, your fan speed control right here, one touch automatic, recycle settings, rear defrost, different modes, automatic mode is available, and of course temperature adjustment, air conditioning on and off, not bad. Some storage right here and power supply, automatic transmission, rear view camera, wood guidance lines, very clear graphic, not bad at all. Your manual shifting, plus for the upshift and minus for the downshift. Not bad. Light brake, some storage right here and right there, as you can see. Heated seats, two stage, high and low, for the driver and for the passenger. Not bad. Works fine, soft leather wrap armrest, and search tray. Auxiliary USB integration plus power supply. Not bad. And of course, manual dim rear view mirror, top lights up top, sunglass counter is also padded. Sweet. A holder, sun visors, just huge. Look at this sun visor, it's just enormous. And vent mirror. But there is no illumination. Grip handles up top. Warning, as you can see. You can definitely feel this true Japanese quality in this car. No doubt about that. Love it so much. So quiet. Engine just does wonders, and soft suspension. Adjustment, sliding. Alright guys, right now let's check back seats, shall we? Of course your fuel cap release located right here, quite easy. Alright. Everything is very nice put together here, like I mentioned before, true Japanese quality. It's just a bargain. Of course, pre-owned. This car runs great. Alright guys, back seats. Child safety locks located right here. And materials to carry over. Soft armrest, storage compartment, power windows, course, speakers, recline, but seats as a fixed system, and back seats is default, 65 display, adjustable headrests, as you can see, completely flat floor, very convenient. Alright guys, let's hop on in with my 63 stature. It's quite easy to get in and out, not bad. Legroom is not an issue at all, and my headroom is pretty good. Side curtain airbags, not bad. Your illumination right here, awesome. Sound at all. Do you want to see a trick? Voila! Seat cup holders, some storage, and storage right here. And of course your soft armrest. It's just magic. Awesome. Love it. Alright guys, back visibility is pretty good. I'm not complaining about the seats, but they are just very nice. Quite soft, supportive. Exquisite Forester interior. Not bad. Alright guys, right now let's check trunk space, shall we? Trunk is huge, as you can see. Your car cover, like so. To fold in receipts, grocery bag hacks right here, and even right here. Power supply, cargo tie downs, and full size spare tire, tools, and jack. Look at it right here. Not bad. One convenient handle to close trunk lid. Easy access for this lock, as you can see. Your fuel cap holder, you can find same manual adjustment for the passenger seat minus seat high. Forester floor mats, all season floor mats, warning. All right, let's hop in. Glove box is not lockable. As you can see, very good size. Of course, you can find your manuals right here. IKEA. Not bad. Thank you.
This car rocks, definitely. Right now, let's shut her down. It's just a Japanese burger. Amazing car indeed. Well guys, hope you enjoy my Zap Luck, this 2013 Subaru Forester. Thanks for watching, thanks for sharing, for subscribing. Take care guys.